All right, day one, Paria River. Just got dropped off by Yermo, the shuttle driver. I will be the first person going down the Paria since the flooding event and the tragedy of the two deaths that occurred in March. So it's about a month out from when that happened. The water's still running pretty good, but it's not flashing. It's just spring snowmelt right now. So I think it's gonna be pretty gnarly, but it's gonna be really good. All right, I think I heard this is the deepest part, so I gotta sneak to the right. Oh shit. All right, time to put on the wetsuit. We're going in the Paria. It's gonna be cold and deep. That's deep. I'm going there. Here we are at the confluence with Buckskin and Paria. Thank you. I love spring water. It's been filtered through hundreds of feet of sandstone before it pops out at the bottom. Perfectly clean and fresh to drink. This one, awesome. Alright, I think I found some quicksand. I want to show you guys how it works. This looks like regular dirt, nothing weird about it. But then, if you go to stand on it for an extended period of time, there must be a layer of water underneath it. So it's solid mud and then water underneath, and you'll start to sink in. And the more you sink in, it's the solid mud on top envelops your entire foot while the water underneath sort of draws you down. And it is so thick and really, oh my God, really hard to get out of. This morning I went up to my waist in this stuff and it literally took like a pretty monumental effort to get myself unstuck because it was starting to draw me down and it was freaky. This shit is real and it is super, super weird. It's so cool though. I am filthy right now. Love it. So the river doubled in size, but there's no tributaries, which means that probably half of the river now is just spring water, which is a nice thought. We found home for the night. Good night, son. Whew. 13 miles today. It's the morning of Saturday. Third day of the trip. And today we go to the start of the high water route. Wraither Arch, judging by its name, you'd think it would be pretty cool. It definitely is. Little arch. Okay. Sour spring. Crystal clear. Oh. Love you, water.
We just passed through the Chinle formation. The river has changed. It looks very different. It's all granular and crumbly. And the river is much smaller than it was yesterday. You can see the red sandstone Navajo layer. Boom, starts to crumble at the Chinle formation. All right, this is home for the night. We're walking out from the trail signature box for the first person to do it in a month and 3 days. I'm stoked. That's what I was looking for. All right, now to the element. Get a burger and Flagstaff somewhere. All right, made it back to the car. Big jug of water. Wait for me. Oh yeah. That was way tougher than I expected. But absolutely amazing.